KTM has been a dominant force in the premium performance segment here in India. They set new benchmarks when they arrived here a few years back and have been on top, be it in terms of performance or sales. Till now, they had a portfolio of 4 motorcycles, which included the 2 Duke and 2 RC sports bikes, which offered a decent buffet of what an enthusiast might like. But come 2017, KTM has decided to take things a notch higher. Welcome to Kredar, people, and welcome the all-new Duke 250. This is the first all-new motorcycle from KTM in recent years here in India. Well, you might say that even the new Duke 390 is all-new, but then it still has the older engine. This here is new grounds up, and we are waiting eagerly to swing a leg over this. Priced at Rs 1.73 lakh ex-showroom Delhi, the new Duke 250 fills the void between the Duke 200 and the Duke 390, but overlaps with the RC 200. So now, KTM fanboys have a tough decision to make. Or is it really tough though? Let's find out. The new Duke 250 is more of a downsized Duke 390 than an upsized Duke 200. This clearly is evident in the kit and styling of the motorcycle, which takes the DNA from Elder Super Duke series. One glance and the edgy design of the Duke 250 is sure to demand a second look. It is sporty, looks sharp, and compared to competition, it is really a very good looking motorcycle money can buy. You have an option of choosing between orange and white paint options for the Duke 250. At the front, you get LED DRLs for the headlamp, which are identical to the Duke 390, but a halogen bulb for the main beam. Then, the instrument console has been lifted from the MY17 RC motorcycle range, so it is updated with more features such as notification for the kill switch, 2 more bars for the engine temperature, actual fuel efficiency and much more. The fuel tank of the new Duke 250 is a larger 13.5 litre unit made out of steel and not fibre. The floating side curl of the fuel tank also adds some funk to the design and sports the Duke 250 branding. The way the rear subframe mingles with the rear panel is just fantastic to look at. We really appreciate KTM bringing in such sporty design here to our market. The seats of the new Duke 250 are larger as well compared to the Duke 200. Also, the riding posture is now different. A little taller compared to the older Dukes, with the ground clearance now at 175mm.
And a new seat height of 830mm.
The tail lamp is a twin LED strip setup with a clear lens on top of it. It looks different but very pulsar-like when illuminated, we think. The new side-slung exhaust might be liked by few but disliked by some. But this comes into play as KTM had to comply with the stricter emission norms, which need a better catalytic converter to be put to use. The exhaust though overall looks good, and even the exhaust note is something you would like compared to the older Duke. But this is a little muted, we think. The N can has an aluminium absorption silencer which helps in keeping the weight down as well. Powering this all-new Duke 250 is a 248.76cc single-cylinder, liquid-cooled, 4-stroke petrol motor producing 30 PS of power at 9000 RPM and 24 Nm of torque at 7500 RPM matched to a 6-speed gearbox. Now, this engine is not all-new and is a downsized version of the Duke 390.
The engine felt typical of KTM's with fewer vibrations at idle, but then being ironed out when the engine is revved higher on the go. The motor has a good mid-range and top-end, making it fun out on the open roads. Top-end remains around 135 km/h as indicated on the speedo, which is not really significantly more than what the Duke 200 can manage.
Also, the Duke 250 has the largest rear sprocket size among the Duke range now. A feature which most would appreciate is the anti-hopping slipper clutch assist which the Duke 250 comes with. This allows you to downshift aggressively when riding hard without worrying about a rear wheel locking. The clutch is super light to use and is ideal for city riding. However, there are no lever adjustments offered on the Duke 250. Another point to note with the new split trellis chassis with a bolt-on rear subframe is that in times of a crash, either the front or the rear can be independently replaced. It also allows better accuracy in the welds while manufacturing, as mentioned by the brand. Suspension duty on the Duke 250 is performed by a 43mm open cartridge upside down front fork from WP and a WP rear monoshock as well. One interesting tweak available on the Duke 250 is that you can adjust the triple clamp on the handlebar with a range of 8mm up or down. The rear shock absorber has been adjusted at level 3 at stock setting. Braking performance is good with enough stopping power available. Although we would have loved the addition of ABS when we put the anchors down, KTM is offering a decent setup with a 300mm front disc and a 230mm rear disc brake with 4 piston calipers at the front and a single piston caliper at the rear. Stay tuned to the Kredar channel for more interesting dope from the world of two-wheelers. Till we meet next time, always wear your riding gear and never forget to have some fun with your set of two wheels. See ya!